Hello everybody, how are you? Are you good today? I hope you are very well. Today is the 8th of April 2020. We have a new lesson today, lesson 24. Are you ready? Okay, let's start. Our grammar lesson today is about irregular action verbs. Irregular action verbs. We know that the regular action verbs is very easy to get the past of them. We put just D or ED at the end of the verb. I'm talking about regular, not irregular. Regular action verbs, we put D or ED. For example, help, helped. We put ed to get the past of the verb help. Play, played. Cook, cooked. Finish, finished. But irregular action verbs is different. You don't add ed to these verbs to tell about the past. With regular verbs, we put just ed. Play, played. But irregular action verbs is different at all. Look here. What's the past of the verb see? So, we can't put ed. This is wrong if you put ed. I can see you now. I can see you. I saw you yesterday. I saw you yesterday. Play is a regular verb, but see is a regular verb. Look here. The past of run, ran. Run is present. Ran is past. Run, ran. I can run for a long distance. I ran 2 miles yesterday. Come, came. Come, came. Come is present. What's the past of the word or the verb come? Came, very good. Not comed, no. We don't put D. But the past tense is came. Why? Because come is a regular action verb. Come, came. Sit is present. Sit, the past of sit, sat. Hide, hid. So sit is present. And the past is sat. Hide is present. The past is hid. Tell is present. The past is told. I told him about the lesson last Friday. I told him last Friday. Told is past. Come is present. The past is came. I came to your home. I came. This is past, not present. The present is come. The past is came. Look here. I go to school every day. This is present tense. I go to school every day. This is present. But in the past, we say, I went to school yesterday. In the past, we say, I go or I went to school yesterday. So in the past, we don't say I go. I say I went. I went. I go in the present. I went in the past. The ducks come to the pond. Look at the verb come. Come is present, okay. In the past, the ducks came to the pond. So what's the past of the verb come? Great, came, you are good. So come is present and came is the past. Read this sentence and get out the present verb. Where's the present tense here? Run. Chipmunks run away. Run is present. Okay, who can change the sentence into the past? In the past, we say chipmunks ran away. Ran away, not run, ran. So what's the past of the verb run? Ran, good. In the present, we say run. In the past, we say ran. Look at the verb sit. The pigs sit in the mud. The pigs sit in the mud. Look at the verb sit. It's a present verb. So how can I change sit into the past? The pigs sat in the mud. So sit is present, sat is past tense. Sit is irregular action verb. It's irregular. So the past of sit, sat, we can't put ed at the end of the verb sit. No, we change the verb from sit to be sat. Look at this sentence. The children hide in the field. The children hide. Hide is present. Who can change hide into past? The children hid. Very good. So hide is present and hid is past. Very good. Read this sentence. The parents tell a story. The parents tell a story. The verb is tell. Tell is present. Can we change it into the past tense? Okay, it changed. The parents told a story. The parents told a story. So the past of the verb tell is? Excellent, told. The past of tell is told. Very good. Now write each sentence using the correct verb. This exercise is from your book, your notebook. Watch it carefully and participate to answer your homework. Number one, the cows come or came from the fields. We need it in the present, now in the present. So the correct answer is the cows come or came from the fields. The cows come or came from the fields. We need it in the present now. Who can answer? The cows come. Come is the present. The cows come from the fields. Come is a present verb, and the past from come is, the past is came. But now we say the cows come. The cows come from the field because we need it in the present time. Number two, choose the correct verb in the present time. The children run or ran down the path. Now, the children run or ran down the path. Who can choose the correct verb? Yes, we need it in the present. The children run or ran. The children run is the correct answer. Run. Yes, the children run down the path because we need it in the present time. We need this verb in the past. We need it in the past. They sit or sat in the field. Who can choose the correct verb? Choose. They sit or sat in the field. Choose it in the past tense. They sit or sat in the field. We know that sit is present, but we need it in the past. So what's the past of sit? Very good. Sat. The correct answer is sat. They sat in the field. They sat in the field. Number four. They all hide or hid in the dark. We need this sentence in the past time. In the past. Who can choose it? They all hide or hid in the dark. Past, not present. They all hide or hid in the dark. We know that hide is present and hid is past. So what's the correct answer? Very good. They all hid, not hide, hid in the dark. We need this sentence in the present. The chicks see or saw their mother. Now, present time. The chicks see or saw. Who can choose? The chicks see or saw their mother. Now, present. Checks. C is the correct answer. Yes, the chicks see their mother. Okay. Choose in the present. Choose the present verb. The chicks go or went with their mother. The chicks go or went with their mother. Now, what's the correct verb? Go, very good. Chicks go with their mother. But we need number three in the past. Choose the past time, the past verb. All of the chickens see or saw the chicks. All of the chickens see or saw the chicks. Choose the past time. Who can answer? All of the chickens see or saw the chicks in the past. Yes, the correct form is so. All of the chickens saw the chicks. We want to choose this in the past. The chickens go or went quickly to their nests. We need to choose it in the past. The chickens go or went quickly to their nests. Choose the past verb, go or went. Who can answer? The chickens? Went, not go. Very good, boys. The chickens went quickly to their nests. Now, the horses hide or hid with their babies. Choose it in the present now. The horses hide or hid with their babies. The horses hid with their babies in the present time. The horses hide or hid with their babies in the present is hide. Very good. Okay. The correct answer is hide because hide is present and the past is hid. Hide is present, happening now, and hid is past. So the correct answer is hide because we need it in the present time. Read and choose in the present verb. The colts come or came to their to the water. The colts come or came to the water. Now, the colts came to the water. Now, calls in the present we use come. Yes, come is the correct answer, and the past of come is came. Come is present and came is the past. The animals run or ran for a drink. I need from you to choose the past tense. What is the past verb here? Run or ran? The animals run or ran for a drink. Past. You will be excellent if you can type the correct form in the chat. Type it. Okay, tell me your answer. The animals run or ran for a drink. Ran. Ran is past. Run, present, and the past is ran. Very good. Number four, read and choose the past verb. Read and choose the past verb. The boys see or saw the horses in the past. What we choose, see or saw? The boys saw the horses. Very good. The boys saw. You are excellent. Number five. Choose the past verb. Yes, choose the past form of the verb. Go or went. The girls go or went to the bar. Choose the past verb. Type your answer in the chat. The girls go or went to the park. The past verb is went. Very good. The girls went to the bar. Number six. Who can answer? The dogs sit or sat with the girls. Choose the present verb now. Present. Sit or sat. The girls. The dogs sit or sat with the girls. The dogs sit or sat with the girls. What's the present verb? Present, sit or sat. Type your answer. The dogs, yes. Sit is present. The dogs sit with the girls. Number seven. Read and answer. The girls tell or told the boys where to go. We want to choose the past form. Past, till, or told. The girls tell or told the boys where to go. The girls tell in the present or we will choose told because it's past. What's the correct form? Till or told? The girls? Told. Very good. The girls told the boys where to go. Now, after we finish this point, we will move to another point. Some prefixes. The prefix is some letters come at the first or at the beginning of the word. For example, re. Prefixes re and un. Re means again. For example, if you looked at this word, rewrite, rewrite, re is a prefix. The root of the word is write, write, just write. Write is a verb. We know the meaning of the word or the verb write. So if we add re to the verb, this is a kind of prefixes. Rewrite means write again. So re means again. Rewrite means write again. Reread means read again. Retell means tell again. Redo means do it again. So prefixes means some letters come at the beginning of the word, yes, to change the meaning. For example, re means again. Re means what? Again. And un means not. For example, unhappy. Unhappy means not happy. So re means again and un means not. Look at this word, refill. Refill. Refill means fill again. So what's the meaning of the prefix re? Means again, yes. Refill means fill again. Look here. Reread. What's the meaning of the word reread? Read again. So the root of the word is read, and re is a prefix. Reread means read again. Un means not. Un means not. Yes. Unhappy. What's the meaning of the word unhappy? Not happy. Who can use the word unhappy in a sentence? I am unhappy today because I heard some bad news. I am unhappy. What's the meaning of unhappy? Not happy. Yes, the root of the word unhappy is happy. But un is a prefix. Means not. I am unhappy means I'm not happy. He is unhappy means he is not happy. We are unhappy means we are not happy. Unkind means not kind. He is unkind man because he didn't help the poor. He is unkind means not kind. Unkind means not kind. The root of the word is kind. And un is a prefix, means not. So what's the meaning of the word unkind, not kind? So we have two prefixes, un and re. Un means not, and re means again. We came to the end of our lesson. See you next time, inshallah, with my best wishes.